3D printing is awesome at printing one-off parts, so today I print this to finish off an awesome electric go-kart. A question I commonly get is, what is 3D printing actually useful for when you finish printing trinkets off Thingiverse? Well, in this video, I'm going to give you some evidence that it is fantastic for making custom parts for your different projects. Our project in question is this electric go-kart, except it's not only my project, it was actually done by one of my students in 2018. In the subject design and technology, students spend almost an entire year working on a major project. This includes 80 pages of written documentation to show the whole design process. This project was done so well, it was actually nominated to be one of the top in the state. Let me talk you through it. The project started with the students buying a secondhand kart frame that was missing a motor because it was previously damaged. They then researched and compared a range of electric motors before selecting one and then designing the mounting system in CAD. After this, they got fabricating, creating the mount for the motor and the speed controller from welded steel. They had to research, test, and assemble all of the wiring for the speed controller and the motor. And yes, they ran it off LiPo batteries to save space and weight. One of the things I really like about this project is it not only has some fantastic traditional fabrication, but also some 3D printing. Some of the main electronics are housed inside this 3D printed box designed in Onshape. This one was printed on the school's Prusa i3 Mark III printer. These next two parts are special because they show a good understanding of the 3D printing process, and they're also designed to be printed in flexibles. The triangular piece is a guard to protect the user from hitting their elbow on the sharp edge, and the second piece covers the battery terminals to avoid any chance of the user damaging themselves or the motor. This student did such a good job and I liked the project so much that I decided to buy it off them. And now it's my project, so let me tell you what I've been doing to it. One of the first things that I did was calculate the maximum current draw from the batteries, connect my laptop to the speed controller, and up the amperage to the maximum safe level. Next up, I turned my attention to the batteries, and part of the reason the student designed it to take RC lipos was the fact that you could take a second set along and swap them for increased track time. The original battery cage was fabricated from welded steel with some foam padding. It worked great, but I wanted a second one for further batteries, therefore I designed one to be 3D printed. This is my first prototype and it's printed from ABS on my open frame TiVo Tornado. Fortunately, the second prototype was spot on and it slots into position and is held by the screws exactly the same way as the first. It's got the added bonus that after you connect everything up, a little battery indicator slots in place and I can just see through my legs how much battery is remaining on each run. The good news is because it's 3D printed, I can continue to print more and more in future as I buy more sets of batteries. My next modification was a matter of convenience and it's to do with how ridiculously low the go-kart is. Despite having small batteries, it still comes in at around 130 kilos and it's quite difficult to move around and load up into my trailer when I want to take it out racing. My solution is pretty unusual, but this is what I came up with. We have a carbon fiber rod with a threaded rod through the middle, holding two pneumatic wheels from the local hardware store, and everything else is 3D printed. It's designed to clip onto the main frame down the bottom and then pivot up to clip onto the upper frame to keep everything aligned. After this, it's simply a matter of lifting up the other end of the go-kart and I can wheel it around like a trolley. This is particularly useful for getting up into the trailer, which now becomes a one-man operation, although still not that easy. One of the things I'll be looking to create in future is some sort of clip-on piece to stop it rolling back and forward in the back of the trailer. When you get to the other end, you simply unload to reverse the procedure and then roll it ready to drive. And how does it drive? Well, it's a lot of fun. Upping the amperage has made it faster, it could do with a little bit more power, but it's still got enough to do slides and spin the wheels with ease. Rather than just talk about it, how about I show you instead? Hopefully you enjoyed that little montage. I certainly enjoyed driving the kart when I filmed it. This video serves as a celebration of the fantastic talent coming through from the next generation, as well as the fantastic uses of 3D printing when you're designing your own custom parts. What's for this kart in the future? Well, I think it will be a pretty nice project to design an Arduino-controlled dashboard with tachometer, speed, and battery voltage, but that's probably going to be a long way down the track. Beyond that, I've got some lipos in the mail that have a higher discharge rate, and I'll be able to further turn the wick up on that motor. Thank you so much for watching. Please leave your opinions in the comment section below on this awesome student project. And until next time, happy 3D printing and go-kart driving. G'day, it's Michael again. If you liked the video, then please click like. If you want to see more content like this in future, click subscribe and make sure you click on the bell to receive every notification. If you really want to support the channel and see exclusive content, become a patron. Visit my Patreon page. See you next time.